The God Goku banner. Should you summon or should you skip? Right off the bat, I'm gonna say that personally, I will be summoning. How many stones will I use? I'll be honest, I don't know. But I guess we'll find out. The banner's good. The banner's very decent. We've got Majin, Vegeta and Broly. Vegeta specifically is still a very decent unit. But then more importantly, we've got the brand new God Goku and Vegeta. And both of them are busted. And then just as importantly, we've got LR Trunks and Vegeta on the banner. Personally, I skipped this guy's banner originally because I knew that he would return on this banner. And here we are. And I am so glad that I skipped his banner because now I can summon on this banner, not only for LR Trunks and Vegeta, but also for Goku and the brand new Vegeta. So that's gonna be sick. And even if I don't pull him, I'll get him with coins. Perfection. Genuine perfection. So the banner's good. If you want to summon, the banner's worth it. But bear in mind, there is no 3 plus 1. There's some banners where you do 3 multis and you get 1 free multi. This is not one of those banners. So keep that in mind. So, but, next month, in only 1 month from now, we'll get a Golden Week. And we don't know what Golden Week will be. But let's say, for example, it's UI Goku and Jiren. Hypothetically, let's just say that. I doubt it, but let's say it is this. In that case, then maybe you might want to save for this instead. And on this, on these banners, for Golden Week, there will be 3 plus 1. So you'll get more value out of your stones. So Golden Week might be better. And furthermore, Piccolo might even return on these banners. Orange Piccolo and Ultimate Gohan. So bear that in mind before you summon on this banner. Not only will it be 3 plus 1, Piccolo and Gohan might return. So these banners might even be better than this one. But this banner is good. It's definitely worth stones. The objectively best decision is to skip this. Furthermore, the objectively best decision is also to skip this. And then specifically to save for and summon on the anniversary banners. The reason the anniversary banners are so good. Well, number one, the banners themselves are like the best banners of all time. But even if you don't look at the banners, we're going to get the discounts on Global, we're going to get the tickets, and we're going to get 3 plus 1, and the banners are really good, and the best unit in the game right now is this unit over here, and they are on this banner, and the Gammas are here, the banners all round are really good, the value for stones is really high, so these two banners are the objectively best banners to save for, but what I will say is, if you want to summon here, it's a good place to summon. If you want to summon on Golden Week, it's a good place to summon, and same for these two banners over here. This banner specifically, honestly, I've got a lot of stones saved up because I skipped Bardock. People that summon for Bardock, Yamcha and banners like that, you deserve to take the L, I'm sorry to say. You should not be summoning on those banners. But if you did, then it is what it is. Should you summon here? It's not the worst place to summon. And furthermore, me being a person that skips majority of banners, I am going to summon on this banner. The better decision is to skip. But if you do summon, it's definitely worth your stones. We'll end it with that. So with that said, if you do plan to summon, let's do a quick subscriber challenge. If you plan to summon, then you have to subscribe because that is the challenge. With that said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, then do subscribe, especially if you failed that challenge because that is the challenge. Also, do leave a like and comment because those things do help out. With that said, thanks for watching and I will see you guys next time.